They did not give up. And they named the girl Faith. And he graduated Bachelor of Science in Business Administration, cum laude, from the University of the East, worked in SDV, and aboard the trustee of Goni Gosho. Ladies and gentlemen, we admired him recently because of a very difficult decision he made. Please welcome the president of Mekeni Food Corporation, Mr. Ruth Garcia. But I'm coming along, a very difficult decision. He had to make, we will learn about it. Was it a bad decision or was it a good decision to have done it that way? The next, please have a sister. The next has 23 years of exposure in the of Eurotex group of companies founded with her late husband in 1968, Mr. Robert Cheng, 51 years ago. Goni Gosho, Filipina Startpreneur recipient and TLDD Bosses Awardee, and the recipient of the Ernst & Young Entrepreneur of the Year in 2017, and represented the country in Monte Carlo for the World Entrepreneur of the Year, Mrs. Natividad Cheng. Alright, six. Yeah. Alright. Can you imagine the learning that you will have having all these people right here? Palakpakan niyo po yung panelists natin. Thank you very much. Time check. It's 10 minutes before 2. My session is supposed to be for 1.5 hours, so we'll get this up. Alright? Papabatiin ko sila, na-introduce ko naman sila. But the first question that I would love to ask us for all of them is this. We're talking about quality business. When would you say that a business is a quality business? May we start with proofs? And if you may want to answer the way you did it for Mekeni recently, maybe you want to define quality business based on that decision.
For me, quality is something above normal. Meaning when in an organization from top to bottom, everyone understands what quality is. And we don't compete with anyone. We don't compete with outside of our own, but everyone understands that we should always be better than yesterday. And based on this, all these procedures, process that we always do, it is something not just for ourselves, but to inspire others.
Can you remind me for Mekeni products?
We have this voluntary recall, one of our products.
Was the voluntary recall of your products or from all over the country, was that an expression of being a quality business and why?
I think so. One, because the reason why we go in business, I tell mo bakit po. Una, dahil sa pangako. Pangalawa, dahil sa utang na loob. Utang na loob, when our parents call us back, 3 out of 5 brothers were working abroad. Because of the eruption of Mount Pinatubo, our barangay in Pola, about 300 families came to our place in front of the school where my teachers were teaching. Sabi nila tatay, anak, the reason why you were working abroad, nakapag-aral mo yun because of the community. Now, I just want to remind you with gratitude. Utang na loob, umuwi kayo, expand the business. From 20 people in 1993, now we have more than 1,300 people working with us. Bakit po sabi namin, dami nagtatanong na mula, bakit kami nag-recall voluntary? Wala naman sinabi ang gobyerno, wala naman sa haka-haka na aming produkto ay possible na may contamination, makakahawa sa ibang baboy, we immediately made a decision. Not because of our brand, not because of Mekeni, but because we care for the community. Kung meron posibilidad na contaminated ang produkto, as only been tested, while we are waiting for the test, we have to make a decision because we love our community. We know and understand kung isa ordinaryo ng farmers ay tatamaan ng virus na kanilang mga alaga, it's like killing their dreams, ang kanilang pagkasal. Because when I was in grade 6, nagsimulan po kami ng backyard poultry layers. Out of 700 heads, in just 3 days, dalawanda ang namatay ng manok sa amin. And atang, they just bought from GSIS as public teachers. Dalawa, ang kapatid po ni Nalit, tatlong approve. Also from teaching, nanghirap din for us to expand ng mga pag-put up kami ng poultry. So in short, I can see the face of Nalay and Tatay. Nalay, tumatas ang pressure, but Tatay never gave up. Sumuto ng veterinary, in-examine yung manok, at nakita ko kung tamang antibiotic ang gagamitin. In the next 2 days, nawala. So we know the burden, we know the feeling. Sabi namin, we don't want our product in any way maging ito ay magdulo at pagpagdala ng virus. So we made the decision immediately for the community.
Very good. How much did it cost you to do that? How much did you have to lose? Do you consider that, is there something you would regret about that decision, which was to some not necessary, but to you was essential?
Ano namin tatamahan kami, and we don't know still, we have financial burden now, but I think with the right mindset, alam ko babawin po kami. Babawin kami dahil ang tao namin, kasama namin sila. Before we are inspiring them, but now they are inspiring us, like they did to us in 1997, when we are about to close our business. Because of the food and mouth diseases, and the economy was the Asian crisis, the five brothers immediately in 10 minutes we made the decision to close the business.
Very
good. And Tatang said, what was the reason why you closed? Did you tell this to our workers? Unfair kayong buhay dahil sa kanila, hindi dahil sa inyo. But then the decision not talking to our people. But people said, we will going to fight, we will surrender, we will expand the business, babagong po tayo. And the same story has been repeated. Babagong po kami ng taas to, dagdag namin, hindi po kami, victim rin po kami ng sitwasyon. And we don't want others to be affected. Alam ko, marami nagpipinda, nagpupuyat, wala po may pinda. Ang mga workers po namin, one month na walang pasok. But yesterday, today, we didn't care, we will start working. It was October 26, and now it's November 26. I don't think that is an accident. That is the most important thing for us.
Thank you very much. Wow, we will get back to you when we pass the mic to my week.